Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the Cleveland Guardians and the Detroit Tigers. John Schaube and Chris Singleton on the call. Postseason baseball, Singy, it's always great to see and be a part of.
Oh, Boog, you just never know what's in store when it comes to postseason baseball. You do know you're going to see some amazing pitching, players coming out of the bullpen throwing 100, some incredible defensive plays, some big knocks, and maybe a mistake or two that'll live on forever. All I do know is I'm pumped up for this one.
First pitch coming your way next. Just a little bit away from first pitch, and starting this one, number 48, what do you look for here?
With the height, the release point creates a lot of tilt on his pitches, so coming into the zone, really hard for the hitters to get on plane, makes it very difficult for the hitters to guess.
Here's the left fielder, Stephen Kwan. And here it comes. Outside low, and we're underway here in game four. Kicks and fires. And a foul ball. That one misses. 2-1. Fastball for a strike.
This guy at the dish excels in two-strike counts. Got to be careful with him out there on the mound.
2-2 now. Line drive caught. Here's the Guardians lineup now. They're facing a pitcher today who's prone to giving up homers, so we'll see. We might get some big swings here today.
Yeah, I think the key, though, and the reason why he gives up those homers is that guys are locking in, they're aggressive, and they have a high confidence level. So I think if that's the approach these hitters take with the stuff he's got there on the mound, yeah, there's a good chance that there'll be some balls that fly a long way. But you can't get too big in your swing. Otherwise, you'll be really frustrated after this one.
Here's your one. Fouled off left side. That's outside. Now 1-2. One out, base is empty. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. Here's Jose Ramirez. And that's too high. On the ground to first. Torkelson takes it to the bag. Guardians go down in order. Guardians fail to score. And now the Tigers get their first opportunity. No score. You're watching the American League Division Series on the show. Back here with my pal Singy. On the hill here today, Alex Cobb. How about a report on him, Chris?
He really relies on working down in the zone with that heavy sinker he's got. You know, it's not as popular to throw that pitch today as it used to be because, you know, guys are looking to hit balls down in the zone, get them up in the air. It's very important for him when facing same side hitters to be able to get it in, especially early in the count, and to opposite guys be able to throw it at that front hip and run it over the inside corner.
Sneaks through, base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first.
And now the DH, Kerry Carpenter. There's a strike. Meadows aboard here at first with nobody out. Cobb checks the runner, and he's back in safely. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. And he deals. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
First strikeout for him in this one. That splitter is maybe the go-to pitch when he's looking for a swing and miss like that. He throws it quite a bit, and that's a good example of the effect it can have on a hitter.
At the plate, Matt Vierling. In there at the knees. And it's 0-1. At the belt and fires. Just off the outside edge. And that is ball one. Man at first, one away. Check swing, he went too far, and it's a strike. Next pitch is outside.
It's a good take.
And now it's filled up.
So here we go. Base runner at first. Could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag to get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Outside, and that is ball four. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
So one out with two aboard, and next will be the cleanup hitter, Riley Green. In the air, left field. Kwan heads after it. Drops into the glove. Let's take a check of the Tigers lineup. Singy, we're looking at a really young lineup here, so not much experience, but it also means they're going to bring a lot of energy to the table most days.
Well, we're in a golden age of young players. I mean, these players, they're getting up to the majors. They're dominating from a young age, bringing home plenty of hardware early in their careers. I mean, before they even get to free agency. So, you know, when you consider all of that, I love seeing the kind of energy that a team like this brings to the yard every day, day in and day out.
First and second, two down. You're in game four of this ALDS. That one is absolutely belted. And it's into the gap. One runs in, headed for the plate. In to score from first, it's 2-0.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
So two down, and next to hit for Detroit, Colt Keith. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter.
He's given up a couple of runs, but the pitch count really not as high as you would think. Might be able to get through this one under 25 pitches.
And that's downstairs and outside. Swing and a miss, and he got him to chase.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good, and then by the time he gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
And a swing and a miss. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. It's now a 2-0 ball game. This is the American League Division Series on the show. Back at Comerica Park, all set for the start of the inning. Here's Josh Naylor.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
The pitch. That one the other way. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One down.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time up, he'll find a hole.
Here's Lane Thomas. Gotta love the intensity of postseason baseball. Players on both sides at such a high level of emotion, everything is amplified. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. In one, hops off the wall, should be extra bases. Now around second, going for third. Not in time, he's safe.
Talk about that intensity, Boo. It comes out of everybody. Think about celebrations by players like Carlos Correa, Jose Bautista, Kirk Gibson. Just iconic moments.
One down. Here's Andrés Giménez. First pitch misses. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
Gonna really need to hang in there with that front side against this left-handed breaking ball.
Larry Bullard, our umpire behind the plate.
But Bullard's got a pretty standard strike zone. Sometimes they'll have you guessing a little bit, but overall, well-respected umpire in the league.
Just missed. And a 2-1 on the way. That's inside. Three-two. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Green pulls it in on the run. Now it's the right fielder, Will Brennan. Singy, he's got a history of coming through into big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. Perez sizing this one up and puts the squeeze on that one. And that'll do it. One left for the Guardians, and they're down 2-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And here's the first baseman, Spencer Torkelson. Cobb back to work. In the air, right side. And they get Torkelson for the out. One away. And the batter will be the shortstop, Trey Sweeney. And that one finds its way through. So a man aboard now with one away. Here's the catcher, Jake Rogers. And that's in there at the knees.
And that's a great take right there. Even though it's a strike, with the situation, runner on first base, you want to keep the ball off the ground. And you swing at that pitch, most likely you roll into a double play.
Righty delivers. Runner on the go. The 1-1 is fouled off. The pitch. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Sweeney at first, one gone. And he chases that one. Two down.
That's about as nasty of a splitter as you'll come across, especially in terms of movement. I mean, that thing tumbles out of his hand and just drops off the table at the last moment. If he keeps it down, it's just so tough to put wood on.
So the batting order turns over. And stepping in is the speedy Parker Meadows. Scored the first run of the game back in the first after a single to reach base.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
Cobb checks the runner. Two outs. That's off the mark. Ball one.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Outside. And the count's even at two. Up the middle, Jimenez. They take the force out, and that is that. One left for Detroit, but they're on top 2-0. Back here in Detroit, and here's the catcher, Bo Naylor.
Taken high in the draft, he's had that top prospect label over him since he put on a professional uniform, but at some point that starts to go away and you've got to produce at the big league level.
Pitch misses there. 1-0. Naylor measures 6 feet even, 24 years old, and he was born in Canada. That one back up the middle and it gets through. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Everything came together for him. Couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle. Timing was just perfect. Got great wood on it, and there was just no chance for the infielders with how hard he hit it.
Here's Brian Rocchio. In there, and it's 0-1. Pitch. Ball one low. The pitch. That one off the mark, and it's 2-1. And a pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. The Tigers leading by two here in game four. Struck him out swinging. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Here goes the runner. And a base hit. Lead runner touches second, headed for third. In there safely.
He was all over that one. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Kyle Manzardo digs in for the Guardians. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Swing and a miss. 4-1.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
First and third, one down. Step off, throw to first. Quad back in standing.
I think you want to get a one-way lead, be very aggressive in the secondary. This hitter not a power guy, so you want to make sure that you can get some length on the secondary lead and perhaps score on a ball in the gap.
Big pitch right here. He's going to try to make a pitch that's going to produce a strikeout or a ground ball double play.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
Now it's Jose Ramirez. He's 0-1. Hard hit left side. They get the force, and that is the inning. Guardians strand a couple. They trail things here 2-0. Set for the bottom of the third, leading off, Kerry Carpenter. Cobb back to work. Outside low, and that's ball one. And that one missing low.
Well, he looks more focused at the plate and working the count after that first at-bat strikeout.
And that one fouled off. And another ball. Late with the swing there. Out to short. Over to first. One up, one down. Now batter, third baseman. And next up for the Tigers, Matt Vierling. The walk and a run scored his first time. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. One down, base is empty. And it's fouled away.
And I think that skill set really upgrades the position, because when you have that kind of speed, it makes the whole team that much better.
That one way outside, ball two. What about him playing another position on defense, one that would require a little more range?
Absolutely, and I think if push came to shove where they had to make a move during a game, it'd surprise a lot of people. You might even be able to put him in center field.
Two up, two down. Now batting, left fielder. Here's Riley Green. Fly to left his first time. Right through there for a strike. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock. And that keeps the inning going.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Wenzel Perez up now for the Tigers. He drove in two with a double his first time up. And it finds its way through for a hit. So that's two straight two-out hits.
Wasting no time. He's two for two now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Colt Heath up now for the Tigers. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Green on second. Perez on at first with two down. Ripped to short. Throws across the diamond. And that is the inning. Tigers strand a pair, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Game four of the division series. And now the first baseman, Josh Naylor. The pitch. That misses the zone, and it's 1-0.
You know, these Guardians just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. They're chasing a lot of pitches outside the zone, and those chases that are turning into a bunch of outs. Can they turn that around and stay within the zone? We'll see, but I think they have to.
And a pitch. And a foul ball. The 1-2. And there's a ball. On a line, base hit.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Absolutely smoked that baseball. What a swing. Sent it out way faster than it came in, of course. 113 off the bat, and no matter where you hit it at that speed, it's tough to make a play on.
Here's the center fielder, Lane Thomas. 1-for-1, he tripled in his first trip. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. Oh, one down. And a foul ball left side. And a pitch. Inside, just missed. And that one hammered back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. So digging in, Andrés Giménez. He's 0-for-1. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. The Tigers up by two, top half of inning number four. And the slider just misses.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there's certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Here comes a pitch. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Left-hand batter waits. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
That one missed. Got him. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout.
Frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
And first offering is fouled off. And here it comes. Foul ball. Kicks and fires. Squirts away a little bit. No advance. Good job behind the dish. That's the third. They take the force out. And that'll do it. Guardians lead one. They trail it here 2-0. Bottom of the inning. And now Spencer Torkelson. The right-hander back to work. Just missed.
Well, these Tigers doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield, and even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
Trey Sweeney up now for the Tigers. And he's already singled in this game. Runner on the go. Swing and a miss. The throw. Tag. And he's out. The 0-1. And ball one.
Still relatively early, but with the pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set them up to do more damage later in this game.
One down, base is empty. Got him looking for the strikeout. He's got to be frustrated with that call.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to, at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Jake Rogers. In there at the knees for a strike. Next offering in there for a strike. That's strike two. Two down, nobody on. And that's outside. Now 1-2.
Well, that's kind of what you expect in an 0-2 count. Excellent job of the hitter to have the plate discipline to lay off of that pitch.
Line drive. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Now into the ball game on defense, Andy Ibañez. He takes over as the new first baseman. Bo Naylor at the plate now. 1-for-1 with a single so far. And Chris, his big strength is defense. But it is interesting, in today's world of baseball compared to when you played, a good defensive catcher is considered differently.
Whatever you get offensively is a bonus, but he's got to put the fingers down. He's got to present pitches to the umpire. They're going to help his pitcher get more strikes.
Now fly ball to right center. Sizes this one up, and he makes the catch. And there's one away. And now, Brian Rocchio. His first at-bat was a strikeout. Right through there for a strike. And it's even up. The Guardians down by a pair, and we're at the top of the fifth. Foul ball there.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. So in now for Cleveland, Stephen Kwan, 1-for-2. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. That misses, and that's ball one.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did. When you look at the elite teams in the game right now, there is going to be the slug, no question about it. But the really good offensive teams combine slug with more contact, with less swing and miss. There's a swing and a drive, and that one hops the wall. Round second, digging for third. And he's got himself a triple. Two outs with a man at third. Stepping up for the Guardians, Kyle Manzardo, who's 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts. Pitch misses inside, ball one.
Yeah, and the domino effect of that is running up pitch counts on pitchers and then either getting them to a place of fatigue or getting into the bullpen perhaps before you get to those higher leverage arms at the back end.
That one fouled off. One of the things that Jim Leland used to say when I was broadcasting with the Marlins, the longer a plate appearance goes for a batter, the more likely it is that something good will happen for the hitter. And another ball. At the belt and fires. That one misses. 3-1 now.
Yeah, and I figured you would get Kotze into this because you had a free dinner at his house the other night.
That is true. And now the lefty fouls one away, and now 3-2. Kwan at third with two away. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And that is that. One left for the Guardians. They're still down. It's 2-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. We head to the bottom of the fifth. And here's the Tiger leadoff man, Parker Meadows. A wind in the pitch. Ball one, no strikes.
On the mound, he had a little trouble back in the first, but it's been a different story the rest of the way. Really settled into this outing nicely.
Swing and he breaks his bat. And he picks it up in foul territory. 1-1 now. That's through there for a strike. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. And now here is Terry Carpenter. Outside low, ball one. Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number five. Next offering is in for a strike. Just missed. One down, base is empty. Good eye in that spot.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Outside, and that is ball four.
Now a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Veerland stands in now and watches strike one. And that one fouled off.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Hit on the ground, might be two. Throws the first in time.
Oh, nice job by the shortstop to field that on the backhand and gather himself, get his feet underneath him. He had a long throw, but he knew he had plenty of time to take that extra step, secure the grip, and finish the throw.
So now it's the four-hole hitter, Riley Green. That catches the outside corner, and that is strike one. And the righty deals. Good eye right there. This to third, Ramirez. And that will end the inning. Tigers leave one as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. All set for the top of the sixth. And now it's switch hitting third baseman Jose Ramirez. The lefty fires. And that's off the inside edge. 1-0. Right through there for a strike.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Puts it away for the out.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Swing and a foul straight back. The 0-1. And there's a foul ball.
Time's starting to run out for this offense, isn't it, Boog? I mean, it's not easy to play in a must-win game, especially when you're losing. Their season is on the line, and they know it.
Check swing didn't go, and it's 1-2.
That pitch wasn't even close, and they still got a check swing out of it. He's going to have to make an adjustment and make it fast.
And that quickly, two away.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Lane Thomas digs in now. He's a guy, Chris's highlights include some of the best throws from the outfield that you will ever see. Definitely one of the best arms of the sport. Fought off foul.
Yeah, the infielders and the catcher can never give up on a play, because if this guy thinks he has a chance, he's going to throw it from the warning track if he has to.
That one misses, and it's a ball and a strike. Two out, space is empty. Out to short, Sweeney. Gathers and throws to first. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Make it six shutout innings for him out there now. It's the Tigers 2 and the Guardians nothing. Well, we go bottom six. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Wenzel Perez. Cobb back to work. Perez goes 5 feet, 11 inches, 205 pounds, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. Strike two. In the air, left side. Kwan settles underneath it. He makes the grab, and a quick out number one.
Now back, second baseman.
Colt Heath, the next to hit.
Well, you got to give him credit out there on the mound. This outing started off a little shaky, but he's found a way to settle in and turn this into a pretty good start. Kind of shows you a lot about his mental makeup as a pitcher.
The next offering misses, and 1-1. On the ground, Rocchio throws the first in time.
That's what a good sinker's designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Two outs, base is empty. And here is Andy Ibañez, getting his first plate appearance of the game here in the sixth after subbing in on defense. Breaking ball in there for a strike. Two down, nobody on, here in the bottom of the sixth. On the ground to short. Slings to first, and that is that. Down in order go the Tigers. They're up 2-0. New inning getting started. So in now for Cleveland, Andrés Giménez. As the lefty gets to work. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Rogers makes the grab, one pitch and one out.
Well, that was a pitch you got to crush. Unbelievable that he missed it right there. And I'm telling you, he is going to be frustrating with himself until his next at bat.
Will Brennan digs in for the Guardians. Outfield playing pretty shallow.
This pitcher's done a good job of disrupting the hitter's timing with a mix of pitches and changing speeds. You want to keep that front foot inconsistent for the batter. Their swings are hesitant, and that's exactly what you want on the mound.
And a pitch. And a foul ball.
You can tell by their swings, this lineup is having trouble gauging speeds. Timing is everything in hitting, and right now they just don't have it.
check swing. He went too far, and it's a strike. Base is empty, one away, late here in game four. Ground ball, left side. Tosses across to first, and a couple of quick outs. And next is the Guardians catcher, Bo Naylor. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. Close but called a ball, and it's 1-0.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position, and that's what he does.
Two down, nobody on. Here in the top half of inning number seven. That one's spoiled, and the count now 2-1.
The hitting's going to come around. He's going to figure it out. But right now, his big asset is the way he plays the game on defense.
And another ball. Ryan Rocchio, next to bat for Cleveland. Two outs. Hard ground ball, base knock.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Here's A.J. Hinch heading towards the mound. And we're going to see a pitching change right here. Number 48 won't go any further tonight. Really solid performance out of him as he leaves with a slim lead. We'll take a break. New arm when we get back. Number 73 comes on now.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Runner at first with two away. And up next for Cleveland, Ryan Rocchio. That's in there.
0-1.
Oh, what a stop from his knees, the throw. And that's a great play for the out.
That was a great job of doing the math. He had the perfect angle, diving stop, completes the play, and that ends the inning.
We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh, Eli Morgan.
Well, I got to think he probably has a little extra in the tank facing his former team, and there's not a player in the league that doesn't get a little extra motivation when he plays against his old squad.
Trey Sweeney up now for the Tigers. And he deals. The shortstop takes the ball.
Well, with both starters out of the game, this quickly becomes a bullpen game. And this is something we see more and more in the game today, especially in the postseason.
Next offering is fouled back. Ground ball, Naylor. He takes it on his own. One up, one down.
Fastball groove right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
Jake Rogers up now for the Tigers. That one finds the zone. It's 0-1. Right through there for a strike.
He doesn't seem to like the pitch up. Hasn't offered on either one of those pitches. 0-2 count now. I think the guy's going to climb the ladder out there.
Swing and a pop up. Rocchio drifts towards it. Squeezes it. Out number two.
Up next to the Tigers, the center fielder,
Back to the top of the lineup. Now the batter now, Parker Meadows. 1-for-3. Bounce to the right. Naylor steps on the bag, and the Tigers retired 1-2-3. Ready to begin the eighth. Now it's going to be Stephen Kwan. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. The wide to kick the pitch. That's in there. 1-1. Ball one there. Here's a 1-1. Fly ball, pretty well struck right field. Perez going back, and that one is out of here. So he just clears the wall, and they're on the scoreboard. It's 2-1.
That could be one of those swings that really helps spark this offense. That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Kyle Mansardo digs in for the Guardians. There's a strike.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Holding on to a one-run lead, and we're in the top of the eighth. That one catches the zone, and that's strike two.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
Looking to get the tying run on base. And that one a little below the knees. And the count 1-2.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Not even close there. And the count is 2-2. Kicks and deals. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Makes the catch, and there's one gone. Jose Ramirez digs in for the Guardians. That's in there, and that's strike one.
Late in the game, everyone gets a little tighter. Way to get ahead on a really good hitter right there.
Puts it in the air out towards left center. Makes the grab, and there are two outs. And now it's Josh Naylor.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, to try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Swing and a ground ball out to short. Jumps, throws, he's in there.
The effort was there with the jump throw. You gotta love it, but it just wasn't in time. Still a really impressive play just to get to that ball and make it close at first, and not every shortstop could even make that play.
Two outs, runner at first, and now the center fielder, Lane Thomas. Curveball over for a called strike.
Typically, the outfield defense will play a little bit deeper just to keep the ball in front, make sure that runner on first doesn't come all the way around to score and tie this ball game up.
The pitch. That one hooked foul. The pitch. fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. Naylor off of first with two away. Way inside, and that hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him. Andrés Giménez digs in for the Guardians, known for his late-inning heroics. Fly ball down the line. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. But not before they answer back with a solo home run. And it's now a 2-1 ball game. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, number 36.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Well, one-run game. Kerry Carpenter getting ready to hit. And a pitch. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. He decides to hold on to it, and they can't get the out.
Waste no time there. That's one of those you classify as just too hot to handle. Hit it on the screws, and it couldn't be fielded cleanly, but you can't really blame the defense in that case.
So, man aboard, Matt Vierling will hit next. Pitch misses inside, and that is ball one. Righty delivers. Pitch misses there, and it's 2-0. Cleveland has some action going in their pen. Tim Herron, the left-hander, up and throwing. Right-handed reliever towards first, and it gets by him.
Just a simple ground ball the other way. They've had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Now here's the Tigers cleanup hitter, Riley Green. Fouled off. He was late. First and second, no outs. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. On the ground, left side, 6-4-3, and they turn the double play.
Got what he was looking for on the mound right there, and his infielders took care of business. Pretty textbook execution between short and second to turn that into two outs.
And now the right fielder, Wenzel Perez. Swings and pulls it foul to the right side. Runner at third, two away. And a good eye there. Big swing and a miss. Swing and a pop up. Foul territory for the catcher. Naylor puts it away, and that will end the inning. One left for Detroit, but they still lead it 2-1. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Jason Foley.
And I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at-bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
The pitch. That misses the zone, and that's ball one. Righty to the plate. Right through there for a strike.
No need to offer that pitch until you get to two strikes. It's just a low percentage of success when you want to try to go after that down and away pitch.
And here it comes. And another ball.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
The 2-1 just missed. Bo Naylor on deck for the Guardians. And the right-hander deals, and that one fouled off.
As a hitter, you don't know what to expect here in the 3-2. If he'll throw a breaking ball 3-1, he'll do it again 3-2.
Payoff pitch downstairs, and it misses ball four.
Well, that could be a tone setter for the inning. Four straight pitches and the leadoff batter's on base. We'll see if the next guy waits until there's a called strike before he takes the bat off his shoulder.
No outs, runner at first. And now it's going to be Bo Naylor. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter.
Your base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get in the scoring position.
The pitch. Little chopper rolls foul.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Next one misses. And a count 1-2.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
That missed by a lot. 2-2. And a swing and a miss. And a strikeout for the first out here in the ninth. Stepping up for the Guardians, Brian Rocchio.
Well, both sides equally as strong, so not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
Swing and a miss. That's strike one. The pitch just missed.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
The shortstop takes a ball, trying to close out a one-run lead here at the top of the ninth. That one ripped, and that gets down into the gap. Around second, on his way to third, heading for the plate. He'll score, and they've tied it. It's 2-2.
Raleigh gets it done in a big spot to get the run across. Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one. Now the go-ahead run's in scoring position, so big opportunity for them to jump ahead late.
So the Guardians lineup turns over. Stephen Kwan digs in for the Guardians. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Lots of anxious fans in the ballpark right now. You can feel it.
One out. The go-ahead run is at second. Next pitch is downstairs.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
That's hard hit on the line. Reaching for it and brings it in. Runner tags at second, and he moves up to third. Now two away. Kyle Manzardo digs in for the Guardians. 0 for 4 with 3 strikeouts and a flyout. That one finds the zone. 0-1. Two outs. Yeah, that's a little high. And there's a strike. Good heater at 98.
Well, if he's going to do something special right here, it's going to happen with two strikes.
And another ball. Two down. Go ahead, run and score in position. Bounce to the right side. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. And we're deadlocked now at 2 apiece. So remaining in the game defensively, David Fry. He'll be the new right fielder after entering as a pinch hitter. Colt Keith up now for the Tigers. 0 for 3 with 2 ground outs and a strikeout. And the right-hander back to work. And that one fouled off. And a pitch. And fouled off. And a pitch. And that's in the dirt. Now 1-2. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, we saw a solid effort out of their starter, and the bullpen is following suit. It's just a good day as a manager or as a pitching coach when you can hand the ball off to multiple arms and get stability from all of their performances.
Andy Ibañez up now for the Tigers. Grounded out to short in his first trip. That one misses. Ball one. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there. And that's off the inside edge. And it's 2-1. That's a little bit low. Trey Sweeney up next for the Tigers. All tied up here in the last half of inning number 9. Next offering in there for a strike. And a full count now.
And boy, that was the pitch. 3-1. You want to be really aggressive on the fastball.
Line drive. That's down. One hops off the wall. Makes it to second. The winning runs in scoring position with one gone.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling.
As soon as that one shot off his barrel, he was thinking extra bases. Really nice job of getting the bat out front, but not hooking around it or rolling over it. Just kept the swing on plane and smoked that thing into the gap.
Winning run in scoring position now, so a clutch AB could end this one.
Lifted in the air right center field. Thomas tracks it down for the out.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Jake Rogers up now for the Tigers.
Oh, how he'd love to walk it off right here.
Out front, rip foul. Swing and a miss. And the count is 0-2. Winning run in scoring position with two away. At the belt and fires. In the dirt. And the runner holds. Trying to send this extra innings. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That's the third out, and we're headed to extras. Tigers leave one. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Back now, and we're in extras. A new arm on the mound here in the top half of the inning. Tyler Holton. So in now for Cleveland, Jose Ramirez.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
There's a strike.
Really good cutter that he's able to front door and back door. That pitch is devastating.
That one's in there. No balls, two strikes.
Well, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes. Even a good pitch early in the at bat, if he's not ready to pull the
got him looking. And that's the first out.
Well, just a beautiful fastball on the inside corner for that backwards K right there. I think the hitter saw it all the way coming from that opposite arm angle. So I got to think he was looking away and just got locked up by the hard stuff boring in on his hands.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Josh Naylor. And there's a ball. One down, base is empty. Fought off foul. The 1-1. And that one fouled off. Here comes a pitch. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
One down, runner at first. Here's the center fielder, Lane Thomas. Runner takes off, and he hits a ground ball right side into the outfield, base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners after a one-out single.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep. Now that sets up a huge at bat in this ball game.
Go ahead, run on base. Andres Jimenez digs in now, and he takes one right on the black. It's 0-1.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. And fouled off.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Lifted in the air down the left side. Green going after it. Drops into the glove. Runner tags for home. Play at the plate. Safe. And they take the lead.
Sometimes all you got to do is your job, and don't overcomplicate things. Keep it simple. Runner third, less than two outs. Put the ball in play, and a nice job with the sac fly.
Now it's the right fielder, David Fry. He walked and came around to score his first time up. And now the lefty, strike two.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
And that one is lifted in the air. Brings it in for the third out. One run, a pair of hits, no errors, and one left on. Last chance to even things up. We head to the bottom of inning number 10. Guardians 3, Tigers 2. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Emmanuel Clase.
Now, this is an extremely confident pitcher. He loves the pressure. Actually likes the one-run game better than a comfortable three-run save opportunity, because that's when he pitches his best.
And here's the Tiger leadoff man, Parker Meadows. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. And the pitch. That one finds the zone. 1-1. That's down and in. A slider missed. Line drive. That's a base hit. And the tying run is on with a leadoff single.
These guys today are so great with handling velocity. They're seeing high speeds day after day, and a nice job of turning that one around.
No outs, runner at first. Next is the designated hitter, Kerry Carpenter. That misses the zone, 1-0. With the winning run at the plate, and here in extra innings. And he takes a strike. Ripped on a line to center. And there's one down. Matt Vierling up now for the Tigers. And Chris, what about the stolen base to try and get the tying run into scoring position?
It's definitely in play, and you want to see it early in this count.
Swing and a drive, deep right field. That one back there. Ball game. And they are moving on. He circles the bases, and the Tigers walk it off to win the series. And they're on to the ALCS.
Well, a really solid division series win. They can move on to the next round and I think relax a little bit more. Congratulations. Get ready for the ALCS.
For Chris Singleton and our MLB The Show crew, I'm John Ciambi. This has been the American League Division Series.
Here now is our final line for tonight. First of the victorious.